Hello, my name is Patrick Silvestro at Xorcom USA, and let's go over the extension module of CompletePBX version 5. The extension module can be found at PBX, Extensions, Extensions, or via the search bar searching for extension. I'm actually only going to search for extend, but you can search for extensions itself also. So as we see here, after searching for extend, I was showed anything on the system that has extend inside of it, including active extensions on the system. Currently, there's only one extension in the system, which is Demo Extension 2000. So let's go ahead and go to Extensions. And as we see here, first off, the first thing we notice is that we have 2001 already inserted in here. The reason for this is that this will allow you to quickly create extensions onto the system. So we call it Demo 2001. And as we see here, it's already created a device description, a password, and a user device. So we just go ahead and hit save. And say we wanted to make 2002, call it Demo 2002. As we see, the same thing here, just hit save again. And I can continue to create extensions like this sequentially until I'm finished, and then just hit apply configuration, and those extensions are in the system and live and ready to go. If we see here, we created Demo 2001 and 2002 along with 2000. So let's go ahead and go back to the main extension. And let me go ahead and explain some of the fields here. So the first thing we notice is that we have a top and a bottom section here. The section for devices here is for endpoints that are registering to the extension. The top half here is the extension itself and its applicable settings. So the first thing we note is the extension number and name, what class of service that we're using for this extension, such as internal only dialing or something of that nature, and the features password. The features password is used on another extension on the system, say that there's a desk phone in the lobby or something like that, and it's only allowed internal dialing, as we showed before. Well, if I dial this extension's features password on that extension for the next call, that particular phone that was internal dialing only will be treated like it's my extension 2000's permissions, and it inserts the call detail records as such. So if I dial this number and then dial out of that phone, for all intents and purposes of that call, that was extension 2000 doing it. We can also assign the email address that will be used for voicemail to email and any other system messaging, along with caller ID and account code settings. The next field here is for voicemail settings, such as attach a voicemail or delete it right after sending. And with anything on the system, if you're unsure of the exact nature of that particular section, you could always mouse over or refer to the reference guide. Moving over to the next section for recording settings, such as do we want to record outgoing incoming calls, any internal calls, or voice message systems, dictation or like voice memos, and these can be emailed to you also. Advanced settings for the extension, along with the user portal username and password, and applying an image to the extension. Follow me settings. And last but not least, the contact information. So let's go ahead and move back to general settings here, and let's expound upon the devices section a little more. So something new with CompletePBX version 5 is the ability to assign multiple devices to an extension and have multiple extensions to a device, or what's better known as hot desking. So to explain this, let's go ahead and do this. Currently, right now, we have a username and a password of 2000 and the password below here, and that's what we would use to assign our desk phone. So I do have a desk phone currently registered to this account, as we see here, just your basic Unlink phone. But say I want to assign my soft phone here that I have on my desktop. How would I do that? Well, first off, we'll go ahead and create a new device. And as we see here, much like before when I started creating a new extension, it's already kind of filled out some information for me. So it's created a user device of 2000_1, which would be the login name now. And let's give it a description. We're going to call it Demo 2000 Softphone. And we see here that it already created a strong password as denoted by the green line under here. It would turn red if it was a weak password, so something like Xorcom doesn't really like. But if we start adding some numbers and some letters and some symbols, A becomes strong password. So we'll go ahead and keep that password. Let's update it because we've made some changes here. Apply the configuration. And as we see here, now we have two devices that are assigned to this extension. So let me go ahead and register this. Let's see, this will be 2001, that password we just created. Everything looks okay. We'll hit save. And as we see, we've actually registered this extension. Let's go ahead and test it real quick. And just to double check, we could take a look at the call reports and see exactly what just happened. So we see here, I was able to dial *97 just a little second ago, and we see the timestamp here. So even though that was a second extension on a soft phone, technically, or a secondary device on the soft phone, it was treated just like extension 2000 regardless. This will go for all extensions that you have assigned to a particular extension. Okay, the last thing to show here in the extensions dialog box is, well, what happens when we unlink a device? So let's go ahead and unlink this soft phone extension we created and see what happens. So it asks us to unlink the device, we confirm it, and we see here it's converted to a hot desking device. And we apply the configuration. And this concludes the extension module of CompletePBX version 5.